Hello everyone, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you the best ISO, or aka Windows modded client, I guess you could call it. It basically tweaks some settings and optimizes performance over security and looks. So the ISO I'm going to be showing you guys today is a Windows 11 22H2 from Ghost Spectre. They have multiple different editions, and you can pick whatever one you want right when you boot into the installation ISO on your USB. The USB size you're going to need is roughly 8 to 16 gigabytes. I am not sure if an 8 gigabyte stick will work, but let me know in the comments down below if it does. I currently use a 64 gigabyte USB, and I've noticed it does not take more than 10 gigabytes. So, first thing you're going to want to do for this tutorial is go to your browser, and then you're going to look up Rufus download. Search that in, go to the very top website, it says rufus.ie, and then once you are here, you just want to download Rufus, and then whatever version is currently the newest. And then once you have that, you want to open another tab, and you want to look up Ghost Spectre Windows 11. Now, I will note that Ghost Spectre does have Windows 10 versions as well, but I personally prefer Windows 11. I like the look and the feel better than 10, and I actually noticed some increase in performance on Windows 11, but I have a pretty high-spec computer, so if you have a lower-end computer, I would still recommend staying on Windows 10. So, once you've searched that, I go to the website Tech Latest. This is where I like to download this version of Ghost Spectre. You want to scroll down a little bit and you want to click 22H2, or if you'd like, they have some previous versions on here as well, like 21H2. So you want to click that. It'll bring you down here. There's a couple different links, and there is different builds of 22H2 that you can download, and it'll tell you the file size as well. So depending on which build you want, I am going for the very top one. You just want to click download, and it will bring you to Mediafire, and it will start your download for you. Now, after that is downloaded, you would like to extract the Windows 11 file that you downloaded. You can either use WinRAR or 7-zip for this. It's all personal preference, and your file might have a password, so make sure you look at that when you are downloading it. I'm pretty sure the password for this file is 22H2U8, and then once you enter in the password, it'll start extracting to your file system wherever you installed it. Alright, so when your file is done extracting, you want to open up Rufus. And this could take a second, and it'll also give you an admin prompt. Just say yes, and then if it asks you to check for updates, just click yes as well. And then a page should open like this. What you want to do is select your USB that you wish to install this ISO to, and then you want to make sure this is on disk or ISO image, and then click select right here. It'll bring you to your file directory system, and then you'd like to go into your extracted folder and click the ISO. Once you've did that, your ISO will load in here, and you don't really need to touch much at all besides start here. Now keep in mind that this will wipe everything on your USB drive, so make sure if you have any important files on it that you should back them up on another drive where they can be safe. And then this could take either a couple minutes or it could take 10 to 20 minutes. It depends on your drive speed and I think also your internet speed. Now, I would like to note that once you are ready and your installation of the ISO has been complete, you just want to restart your computer and boot onto your USB. If you're watching this video, I'm going to assume that you know how to boot onto a USB. If you don't, you can simply boot into your BIOS and select your USB as the boot option, or you can click your boot menu key when your computer's booting up. This differs on your motherboard model. For me, it is F8, so I spam F8, and then you will just click your USB name. For me, I will click 64 gigabyte SD USB. and it will bring you right to the ISO. And just like a normal Windows installation, there's going to be a couple different options. There is going to be a compact version of the Ghost ISO and a Superlight version. Compact version is just most of the bloatware removed and etc. And you can either have Windows Defender or remove it. And then there's another version called Superlight. And then there is a addition where you can remove Windows Defender or keep it. Or you can also remove the start menu, and it'll come with a custom app for you to customize your start menu and etc. like this. I personally went with the Superlight version, and I also still have Windows Defender because I prefer that little bit of extra security, because I don't do what normal people do on my computer. I am downloading files like this and testing them out for you guys. So once you have that, you want to boot up. And then, depending on your hard drive or SSD speed, it could take a second to install. So when you boot up, it should not ask you for your Microsoft account or anything like that. It should start you offline, but you can still add your Microsoft account, so you do not have to worry about anything like that. But when you boot up, you should have some icons on your screen lined up. Not like this, of course, because I have a lot more. I already have my edition all set up and ready. There is going to be a new ghost mode option when you right-click. God mode, ping test, reduce memory taskbar, and power options. So this is a new feature. And then also you're going to see a ghost toolbox. You can open that up. It'll give you an admin prompt. Just click yes. And a window like this will open. This is essentially a whole bunch of pre-built things that Ghost has put in for you guys. Like DirectX tools and other stuff to help your computer run right here. As you see, highly recommended to install. This Visual C++ is something just to like help games and programs run. Some programs require this Visual C++. For instance, the Rockstar game launcher, what GTA 5 runs off of, you need this visual file to run that. DirectX is just something for your graphics card, and it runs games for you. And then here you can see is a toolbox to see what has been added or removed from this custom ISO. And then up here you also have some things like tweaks, fixes, cleaner, and other options. Personally, once in a while, I like to come up here and clean my Windows cache. So what I'll do is I'll just type 3, since there's a little 3 next to the option. Click Enter. It'll bring this up, and it'll say Clean Now or Back to Menu. I'm going to click 1 to Clean Now, and then Enter. And it will be doing all the stuff like turning off delivery optimization. And then what this is going to do is clean all your cache files to speed up your computer a little bit. And this can also take a longer time depending on what type of drive you have, depending on if you have an SSD or a hard drive. Hard drives will take a bit longer than a solid state drive. And then after you have this all set up and everything of your choosing installed from this, you can be done and do what you'd like. There are a couple things that I want to explain to you, though. It does come in with some browsers built in for you to install on this Ghost tool. But one issue you might run into if you're trying to do it manually is if you go to your settings and try to add your online Microsoft account, that will not work and you'll get an error code. So what you'll have to do is right here you'll see change administrator name or add a new user. This is the setting you will have to use to add an online Microsoft account. And then your Microsoft account you're going to add, it's not going to come as admin, and it could have a few issues. So what you could do is just make sure you give your Microsoft account admin and then delete the local account that's on your computer. So before doing any of this, if you would like, if you're okay with not having an online Microsoft account, then you don't have to worry about this. If you prefer to have your online Microsoft account linked to this, which personally I do, you should log into that online account before running any of these options, as they will go away if you switch to a different account. Not all of them, say like these drivers down here, those won't go away. But some things that you install up here, like Firefox, they will. Other than that, that is the end of this. Up here you can see my edition right here, and then I had the Superlight Plus Defender. And Yeah, this will also delete the security measures and system requirements. So if you're on a very low-end computer, you'll be able to install this because TPM and all of the Windows 11 security things, they get disabled on this ISO. And yeah, you can also right here allow higher compression for your drives. I wouldn't touch that unless you know what you're doing, by the way, because it could corrupt some files. And that is going to be the end of this tutorial, guys. I hope you liked it and found it useful. If you did, make sure to like, subscribe, let me know what other videos you'd like to see in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next tutorial. Peace.